Welcome to Learner's Planet, my dear children. Children, this is session 8 about health and hygiene. In the previous sessions, we studied about all the main food groups, the 5 main food groups, including roughage, and also we studied about water, which forms a very essential part of our diet, though it is not considered to be main food group. So children, in this session we are going to study about diseases in detail. So children, let's start with this session. Yes children, first of all you should get familiar with the term diseases. Children, lack of any component of food in our diet cause diseases. Right? If we will lack any of the component of food amongst the 5 main food groups, even the roughage and all the food sources which we discussed in the previous sessions. So children, all the food groups are very much important and we should include it in our diet. So if any of the food source or any of the component of food is lacking in our diet, then it will cause disease. So children, what is actually meant by disease? Let's see. Yes, a disease is a state in which a function or a part of the body is no longer in a healthy condition. Alright children, so children, disease is actually a part of body which is not in a healthy condition. That means it can also be termed as, or it can also be said that, an abnormal condition which affects the body of any living organism is known as disease. Alright children, so any of our body part is not functioning properly, and if it is not in a healthy condition, then it is termed as disease. So children, disease is actually considered as a medical condition. It is any condition, that means a medical condition, that causes pain, infection, disorder, disability, etc. So children, it may be caused by certain external factors, right? So diseases can be caused by internal factors also, that means lack of diet, and even by external factors also, that is due to germs or harmful organisms. So that cause diseases. Alright children, so always remember that disease is an abnormal condition which affects our body, and it is considered to be a medical condition. Alright children, so children, there are mainly 2 types of diseases. They are majorly categorized into 2 types. The first one we will see now. Yes, non-communicable diseases and communicable diseases. So diseases are of 2 types, non-communicable diseases and communicable diseases. Children, now we will study about each of them in detail. So let's start with the communicable diseases. Yes children, what is meant by communicable disease? Yes, the disease which is actually capable of being passed on readily from one person to another is actually known as communicable disease. Or in other terms, we can say that the diseases that can spread from one person to another person are called communicable disease. right? So what are communicable diseases? Yes, the diseases that can spread from one person to another. That doesn't mean that a person which is healthy will not have any kind of disease or will not suffer from any kind of disease. It is not possible, right? If the person is healthy, but if it is lacking some or the other important food group or important component of food in his or her diet, then they can fall ill, right? And so the person which is healthy will be in a diseased condition, and that diseased person, and that diseased person, if it is not taking care, right, and if that disease passes on to another healthy person, that are called as communicable diseases. Alright children, that is why it is termed as communicable. Alright children, so these diseases are transmitted from one person or even animal to other person or animal. Alright children, for example, if a dog bites a person, then also a person can fall sick, right? A person can suffer from rabies. Alright children, so these diseases are transmitted from one person or animal to another person or animal. Alright children, so these are the diseases that can spread from one person or animal to another one. So children, you must be thinking that a communicable disease is communicated either by air or touch, right? Well, children, there are other modes of spread also, the other modes of spread of communicable diseases. So let's see. Yes children, there are some common communicable diseases also. Let's have a look children. The common communicable diseases are malaria, measles, typhoid, cholera, chickenpox, tuberculosis, common cold, polio, etc. So these are some of the common communicable disease which you might have heard from anywhere, from your teacher or either from your parents or friends also, right? So we will see all the diseases, or we will study about all the diseases in detail. But children, first we will see that a communicable disease is communicated only by water or touch, or are there any other modes of spread of communicable diseases? Yes, let's see. Yes children, communicable diseases not only spread through air or touch, it also spreads through water and food also. So in all we can say that communicable diseases spread through air, water, food and touch. So communicable diseases spread through all these modes. Alright children, and children, you will be amazed to know one more thing, or you will be interested in knowing one more thing, that there is something called incubation period. But what is meant by incubation period, children? Yes children, you might know that germs take place to grow and then they produce the disease in the body. Alright, so what is that time period called as? Yes, that time period is called incubation period. That means the gap of time between the entry of the germs into the body and the appearance of symptoms on the human body, or the body which now affected because of the entry of germs into it, is called incubation period. Alright, children? So, children, there is a gap of time or there is a time period in between the entry of germs into the body and appearance of symptoms, means appearance of disease into the body, is called incubation period. So, children, let's study about each of the common communicable diseases in detail. So, children, the first one is malaria. Children, malaria is caused by mosquito bite, and that is why it is called as communicable disease, right? Because mosquitoes and some other insects transmit germs through their bite to the human body, and when a mosquito bites a person infected with malaria, insect sucks in these germs along with its blood, with the human's blood. And when same mosquito bites a healthy person, then that person gets infected with malaria. So, you can see the connection between a mosquito bite and the body to which it attacks or to which it bites, right? So, is it communicating? Yes, this is communicating. That is why we call malaria as a communicable disease, right? As we studied or as we discussed that there are some modes of spread of communicable disease, like it will spread through air, water, food and touch or contact with the other person, right? But here we are not talking about a contact between a person to person. This is a contact between a mosquito and a person, right? So children, are you clear with this? So children, when the mosquito bites a healthy person with the same germs of malaria, right, then that person gets infected with malaria. So it is a type of communicable disease. So to take care, we have to take certain steps. Alright, children? So first of all, we saw that it is caused by mosquito bite and its incubation period is 10 to 14 days. What is meant by incubation period, children? We just discussed. Yes, it is the gap of time between the entry of germs into our body and the appearance of symptoms on our body is called incubation period. So once a mosquito bites a person, right, then the germs of that mosquito will enter into our body, and after that symptoms will occur on our body, but after some time, right? So what is that time called? Yes, that is called incubation period. So malaria is caused by mosquito bite and its incubation period is 10 to 14 days, means the entry of the germs have now taken place in our body, but the symptoms will appear after 10 to 14 days. So till 10 to 14 days you will not feel anything, right? Till 10 days, 9 to 10 days you will not feel anything, but after 9 to 10 or 10 to 14 days some symptoms will start appearing, through which you can come to know that now your body is not in a proper or healthy condition. That means you are suffering from one or the other disease, right? And then you consult doctor. So children, the symptoms of malaria are, which will appear in between 10 to 14 days, the symptoms are fever, constant shivering, that means you will shiver all the time, you will feel cold, then perspiration means, yes, you will feel like you are having sweat, your body will release some sweat out of it. You can see, you can observe it on your skin. Then headache, then body ache, means your head will also pain a lot and your body will pain a lot, and vomiting. So these are all the symptoms of malaria. If this occurs, that means you might be or you may be suffering with malaria. Alright children, so children, to take care of a malarial person or a person who is suffering from malaria, we must get the blood test done of that person to confirm whether a person or a patient is suffering from malaria or not, and do visit doctor so that doctors can prescribe medicines. Alright children, so children, let's see another type of communicable disease. Yes, measles. Measles spread by very tiny organisms called germs, right? So these are also caused by, this is also caused by germs, and it is a type of communicable disease. How is it? How can we say that it is a type of communicable disease? Yes, we can say because when an infected person coughs or sneezes, these germs are released into air and can infect a healthy person. And sharing an infected person's handkerchief, towel, clothes, etc. also spreads these germs to a healthy person. So this can cause measles. That is why it is a type of communicable disease. And its incubation period is 8 to 12 days. That means the symptoms will occur after 8 to 12 days. And the symptoms of measles are, we will be able to see that a patient is suffering from measles by the symptoms: cough, fever, muscle pain, runny nose, then redness of the eyes and sore throat. Alright children, so sore throat means your throat becomes dry, right? In normal condition, your throat is not in a dry condition. But when you are suffering from disease like measles, you will feel that your throat has become dry and you are not able to swallow the food properly. Alright children, so we studied about measles. Now we will see another one. Yes, typhoid. Children, typhoid is also a type of communicable disease which spreads by food. That means a contaminated food. A food which is not covered or which is not boiled or which is not properly prepared, or if it is attacked by germs, then it is a contaminated food. So typhoid spreads by contaminated food, and its incubation period is 14 to 21 days. That means the insects like flies transfers disease causing germs when they sit on any foodstuffs. And when we consume these type of foodstuffs, and if we are having this type of food containing these germs, then they will cause typhoid. So children, the symptoms of the typhoid which occurs to such patients are severe headache, then fever, and dry white coated tongue. Means your tongue will be white in color. That is why when you consult the doctor first sees your tongue, right? And if it is white in color and it is dry, that is the first sign which shows that you are suffering from typhoid. Alright children, so now let's see another communicable disease. Yes, another one is cholera. Children, cholera is a communicable disease which spreads through water, right? So it is a waterborne disease. Like typhoid is a foodborne disease, This is a waterborne disease. Like we drink water every day and we will suffer from cholera. No, it is not correct. If we consume or if we drink contaminated water, then we will suffer from cholera. So children, the feces or any type of excreta of insects, if it mixes with the clean water, then it will be a contaminated water. Alright, so you should always take care that you are drinking clean water, a water which is covered. And if you are drinking from any packed material or bottles, then make sure that bottle is packed very finely. It should not be broken or opened. Alright children, so do take care when you are out of your home. So children, its incubation period is 1 to 5 days. And the symptoms of cholera which appears on the patient are vomiting, the patient or the person feels very very thirsty, they drink water again and again, and severe watery diarrhea. That means a person is also suffering from such type of symptom, like severe watery diarrhea means loss of water from the body, right? Through feces, through excretion. Alright children? So children, in severe watery diarrhea, what happens? The feces look like rice water, right? And children, you might have seen on TV that many small children are treated with ORS, WHO ORS. Why they are treated? Yes, they are given ORS when they are suffering from diarrhea. Alright, and they are given ORS, which means oral rehydration solution. What it is called as? Oral rehydration solution, because that solution is given orally, and plenty of other fluids should also be included in their diet, right? So this should be included in the diet, fluids should be included in the diet of the patient or the person who is suffering from cholera. Now let's see another one children. Yes, chicken pox. Children, chicken pox is caused by germs present in the air. And so we can say that this disease spreads through air. It easily spreads through the person having sneezing or coughing. Alright children? So children, its incubation period is 10 to 21 days. And the symptoms of the patient suffering from chicken pox are fever, headache, itching, pain and rashes. Means it is a type, rash means it is actually a change of the skin due to its color. It affects the color of the skin. It becomes red in color. Right? So rashes occur on the patient's skin who is suffering from chicken pox. Alright children? So let's see another kind of communicable disease. Yes, tuberculosis. Children, this disease is caused by germs present in the air, the same which we saw in chicken pox. So children, it also spreads through air and its incubation period is 4 to 6 days. And the symptoms of the tuberculosis patients are cough, then loss of weight because of the loss of appetite. Loss of appetite means a person does not feel hungry. And if a person does not feel hungry, they'll not eat the food. And if the person does not eat the food, then obviously there will be loss of weight. Alright children? And Another symptoms are excessive weakness. A person will feel very tired and very weak and very lazy. And even rapid pulse means the heartbeat will increase, and chest pain. So children, these are the symptoms of the patient suffering from tuberculosis, and it is spread through air, so we call it as a communicable disease. Now let's see another one, children. Yes, common cold. Common cold is also caused by the germs present in the air. That means it spreads through air, right? And common cold is also known as or called as influenza, means flu. Because the flu which is present in air, a flu, a type of germ which is present in air, causes common cold. And common cold and influenza are actually common infections which especially occur during winter season, and it spreads through air, and so its incubation period is 1 to 3 days. That means the symptoms on the patient will occur after 1 to 3 days, and so we can come to know that a person is suffering from common cold by the symptoms, which are fever, cold, cough, sneezing, headache, and vomiting. So by these symptoms we can come to know that a person is suffering from common cold, and it can be controlled by taking medicines on time, by treating on time and consulting doctor. And cough can also be treated by home remedy, that is steam inhalation. Alright, if you will ask your mother will show you that what is actually steam inhalation. You have to boil water in one vessel and then you have to take steam. That means you have to breathe the boiled water or the water which evaporates. That evaporated water you have to breathe in. Alright children, so cough can be cured by steam inhalation also. Alright children, so children, I hope that you enjoyed and learned about communicable diseases.